I'm starting a new series on genetics and mental health this week. In this video today, we're going to discuss the risk of getting depression, panic disorder, or bipolar disorder if you have a family member with the condition. We'll then talk about epigenetics and how you can lower your risk of mental unwellness, even if these conditions run in your family. Finally, I'll give you 5 practical tips for influencing epigenetics within your body. Hi, I'm Dr. Janelle Sinclair, and I'm a biochemist and natural medicine practitioner. And on this YouTube channel, we discuss natural remedies for depression and anxiety. Make sure you subscribe and hit the bell button so you're notified about our new weekly videos. Major depressive disorder runs in families. There is a genetic component to this condition. If you have a first degree relative with major depression, like your mum, dad, brother or sister, your risk of depression is increased by 2 to 4 times. So that means compared to someone in the general population that has a risk of 8 to 16% of getting depression in their lifetime, your risk increases to 16 to 50%. But remember to keep this in perspective. You also have a 50 to 84% probability of not getting depression too. When it comes to panic disorder, if you have a first degree relative with this condition, your risk is increased by 3.5 to 7 times. So compared to someone in the general population that has a risk of 2%, your risk of ever having panic disorder increases to 7 to 14%. With bipolar disorder, it's a very uncommon condition with less than 1% of people in the general population having it. Your risk will increase by 5 to 10 times, leading to a 5 to 10% risk of having bipolar disorder in your lifetime, if you have a first degree relative with this condition. But keep in mind that there's still 90 to 95% probability of not ever getting bipolar, so focus in on that. When we talk about mental unwellness running in families and there being a genetic link, lots of people think that it's a life sentence, that it's inevitable that they will get a mental illness. They may believe that they can't change this risk and that their genes are a blueprint that can't be modified. Well, people are overlooking 2 vital things here. Number 1, that your environment, your diet, your stress levels, your lifestyle, your relationships, and your thought patterns all impact your risk of mental unwellness. So it's not all about your genes, and it's also about your environment, and you can learn to control many of those things. Point number 2 is that your lifestyle choices interact with your genes. Did you hear that? Your lifestyle choices interact with your genes. Now, this is an exciting area of research right now, and it's called epigenetics. Epigenetics refers to the external modifications to DNA that turns genes on and off, and methylation is one of the major ways to do this. I know that might sound quite technical, but the key thing here is that you can turn your genes on and off, or at least down, up and down to some extent. Another example of epigenetics is the process that makes one cell a brain cell and yet another a skin cell. These cells have the same genetic material and the same genetic code, yet they're different from each other. This is achieved by epigenetics, the process of turning some genes on and turning some genes off. Why is this relevant to mental health? Well, it puts the power back into your hands. Epigenetics shows us that we can decrease the risk of mental unwellness, even if it runs in our family, by turning down the expression of the bad or dirty genes and turning up the strong and beneficial genes. Dr. Ben Lynch, author of the book Dirty Genes, describes it this way, that rather than seeing your genes as a blueprint that lays down the law, it's more like a document written up in the cloud that you get to edit and revise and negotiate with every moment of your life. These genes don't even speak with a single voice. They're a committee, and sometimes they disagree with each other. You may have genes that are yelling, low mood, poor sleep, or anxiety. But you also have other genes saying, be calm, have good focus, and be happy. What we need to do is turn down those dirty, bad, or mutant genes and turn up those beneficial genes. In a minute, I'm going to discuss general recommendations that can help turn up the volume on those beneficial genes and turn down the bad genes. But I just want to let you know that over the coming weeks, I'll be discussing genetic testing, methylation, and specific genes like MTHFR and COM-T that can impact mental health. I'll talk about particular dietary changes, lifestyle modifications, and supplements that you can use to compensate for a weakness or mutation in that gene. If there's a particular gene that you want me to discuss, why don't you let me know in the comments section below. Now let's discuss 5 tips to support your epigenetics, which can help turn down those bad genes and turn up those good genes. Now, unfortunately, science isn't clever enough yet to know how to turn specific gene expression up or down. So keep in mind that influencing your epigenetics is going to have a positive but broad effect. But in the coming weeks, we'll talk about specific genes and how to compensate for any particular weaknesses. So moving on to epigenetic tip number 1. Eat vitamin B12 and folate-rich foods. Vitamin B12 and folate are methylating agents in the body. We've just discussed that methylation is the key epigenetic mechanism that helps control your gene expression. So we want to consume high amounts of natural folate and vitamin B12 to support methylation. The top folate-rich foods include spinach, asparagus, avocado, broccoli, beets, seeds and nuts, beans, peas and lentils, romaine lettuce and citrus fruits. The top vitamin B12-rich foods are eggs, milk, cheese, meat, fish and poultry. Some soy and rice beverages, as well as soy-based meat substitutes, are fortified with vitamin B12 too. Epigenetic tip number 2, take a multivitamin or B complex containing methylfolate. As well as eating folate and vitamin B12 rich foods to get the methylating nutrients in the body, you could also consider taking a multivitamin or a B complex that contains methylfolate. Methylfolate, also known as L5-MTHF, is the active form of folate in the body. Avoid any supplements that contain folic acid, as this puts more stress on the methylation pathways. I recommend the Seeking Health brand of supplements that has been developed by Dr. Ben Lynch, author of the book Dirty Genes. His products never contain folic acid and have the best methylating nutrients in them. The optimal vitamin multivitamin methyl 1 or the B complex plus would be good products to consider. If you'd like to support this YouTube channel, consider purchasing the Seeking Health products through our affiliate links in the description below this video or via the links on our website. Epigenetic tip number 3, remove toxins from your environment. The reason that we want to remove toxins from our environment as much as we can is because they have a negative effect on epigenetics. They will lower the methylation in the body. Exposure to toxins can lead to more expression of the bad or dirty genes. Here's a few tips on how to clean up your environment. Number one, filter your water. Two, avoid plastics for use with foods. Avoid non-stick pans or cookware and use natural cleaning products and cosmetics. Finally, eat organic foods. If getting hold of organic food is difficult for you or the cost is prohibitive, then try to avoid the fruit and vegetables that are most contaminated with pesticides. The top 12 contaminated foods are also known as the dirty dozen, and they include strawberries, spinach, kale, nectarine, apples, grapes, peaches, cherries, pears, tomatoes, celery, and potatoes. Epigenetic tip number four, improve your sleep and manage your stress. Poor sleep and increased stress can impact your epigenetics. So create good habits around your sleep, going to bed at the same time each night by 10:30 p.m. Don't drink caffeine after 2 p.m. and if you struggle with anxiety, I'd suggest that you give up coffee altogether. Check out my video on coffee and anxiety for more information on that. To help you sleep, make sure that your room is very dark. Do everything that you can to make sure that happens. Get blackout curtains and remove any clocks or devices from your room that shine light. Don't watch screens at least 1 hour prior to bed, and if you do, then install blue light filters on computers, phones, and devices. Blue light is known to reduce the production of melatonin, your sleep hormone. Diaphragm breathing can help reduce stress levels and improve your sleep, so consider doing that for 10 minutes before bed each day. Moving on to epigenetic tip number five, do genetic testing to see if you have any weaknesses in the methylation genes. Next week, we'll be talking about genetic testing and the different genes that are of interest to anyone with a mental health concern. I'll touch on the methylation genes and then I'll do an in-depth video the week or so after talking about the MTHFR gene. If you'd like to find out more about epigenetics, consider purchasing Dr. Ben Lynch's book, Dirty Genes. You can find a link for his book in the description below. And if you'd like to support this YouTube channel, consider purchasing his supplements through the affiliate links you'll find in this description as well. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.